ice? Call the official Arendelle Ice Master and Deliverer. For all your ice needs, call the guy with the reindeer. And yes, that's a thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to, for the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration.
I'm tired, but excited.
I can't be tired when you're excited.
It's nice. I posted on Facebook.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Disney's Hollywood Studios welcomes you to, for the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, all people of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land, please welcome Her Majesty, the Queen of Arendelle.
Let it go, not yet. better way.
Where do you want to start?
Wherever a good story starts, the beginning.
It was a dark and stormy night.
Nope, it sure wasn't.
It was a long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
No, not that either.
All right, Fozzie Bear, where was it?
It was kingdom of Arendelle.
Two sisters who loved each other very much.
Princess Elsa and Princess Anna.
Elsa was born with special powers.
Magical powers that created ice and snow. Anna loved to play with Elsa's magical snow.
And she creates a snow monster.
We're jumping ahead in the story. Back it up, pal. This is the part where Elsa hits Anna with her powers. Pachooey! And freezes little Anna's head.
They rush her to the trolls. If you don't know what a troll is, consider yourself lucky.
What?
Mischievous creatures, strange magic. I never liked them. One of them stole my girlfriend in college.
Oh.
It was Dwayne Johnson, the Rock.
Gamran Hobby, the king of the trolls, was able to fix Anna's head. Though he had to remove all memories of magic.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it, but also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy.
Oh dear. They decided to keep Elsa's powers hidden from Anna. Then the saddest thing happened.
No more snowmen?
No more snowmen.
You know what'll make me feel better?
Cheesecake?
I am not that fat.
What's
happening?
I'll explain it to you later.
Where is that boat going?
To a farm where it can run free.
Is the boat sinking because that guy won't sing?
Yes.
Found herself dreaming of the possibilities of opening the castle gates for the first time in... It's Coronation Day!
Oh, yeah! And would you believe it? Anna did meet someone tall, dark, and dreamy. Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
Don't like him. His eyebrows are too perfect.
Okay, you're grumpy because I said he was dreamy.
Oh, you have said that already.
I'm gonna say it again because he is dreamy. Oh, Hans, you're so dreamy. Look at his face.
If he's evil and you know it, clap your hands. It was coronation day. They all arrived at a royal coronation.
Elsa was very nervous, but she was able to conceal her powers just long enough to be sworn in as queen.
And then they parted.
If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it. If you like it, then you should have put a ring on it.
Okay. All right. As Beyonce's stunt double, I say no.
Well, let's talk about the chocolate, the sister's favorite food.
It was awkward between Anna and Elsa. They haven't seen each other in years. All of that
was changing?
Because Hans came back, and they danced the night away.
Yes, Hans.
Don't you just love true
that
love?
That is not love. They had only just met.
Well, you don't know a thing about love, then.
Tragic.
Oh, yeah, tragic. Well, a wise woman once said, love is an open door.
Stop watching The Bachelor.
I would rather shut
up. Yes. Love.
Can I say something crazy?
Well, sure.
The Oscar goes to La La Land! A little late there, buddy. Nice laugh. Ah! Like an evil villain or something. I don't know.
Speaking of evil villain, I found Waldo. Look at that.
Oh, hi,
Waldo. Hi, wave to everybody, Waldo. Go ahead.
She didn't want to do it.
No, she didn't. No, it's all right. She's incognito.
She is?
Mm-hmm.
Just like Queen Elsa was.
Yes.
And she said, and I quote, you can't marry a man you just met.
Well, Princess Anna said, and I quote, you can if it's true love.
None of that mattered. Everything changed. It had nothing to do with love.
Okay. Anna did push Elsa too far, and it caused her to accidentally shoot ice all over the ballroom.
People called her a witch.
Yeah.
A sorceress.
Oh.
She impaled someone.
She impaled... No, she did not.
It's on the bonus features.
What have you been watching?
That guy go, ha-ha.
Well, they were scared.
Not nearly as scared as the queen who ran away across the fjords of Arendelle, freezing everything in the process.
She froze all of Arendelle, sending our beautiful kingdom into a cold, dark curse.
It was beyond cold. It was frozen!
Okay. But Elsa couldn't come back now that everyone knew of her icy powers.
I see the problem. Snow untrusted her.
Are you done?
Oh, chill.
Our queen was lost and alone, but for the first time in her life, she felt truly free.
This song is for you, weird laugher. The song.
No, the song is over. It's time to let it go.
The cold never bothered me anyway. Oh.
That is a good thing because guess what? It's going to get a lot colder. Nasty Princess Anna, feeling like this whole mess was her fault.
Which it was.
Ran out into a blizzard to find her sister, which she did.
They reached the North Mountain and Queen Elsa has built. She built this castle.
I
built this castle on rocks and trolls. Excuse me.
Oh my gosh. Oh well. Oh, golly, always gotten closer. Oh, look at that.
Who is it?
I don't know, but he's pretty.
Who is it, everybody? It's Clip-Clop.
Oh, boy. It's Kristoff.
How are you doing, Flip-Flop? Listen, we didn't recognize you, Crunch-Wrap, without your reindeer.
Oh, well, Sven found himself some carrots. He had just gotten...
To the what?
The cook.
Look, that's beside the point.
Huh?
You know, I kind of helped out.
What?
A lot.
Oh, well, excuse me, Mr. Dimples. But we were just... What is this? Oh, it's my new happy place.
Yeah, well, sweetheart, human resources is going to find you a new happy place.
Okay. I was just reminding the nice ice harvester that you didn't want to help out in the first place.
Well, of course I wanted to help. I mean, I couldn't sell ice in the middle of a blizzard.
Oh, I'd buy it.
She would, because of the hot flashes.
Well, and Princess Anna never would have made it up the North Mountain without my help.
Not to mention, you liked her.
You want to kiss her?
Well...
A little bit?
A little bit.
I mean,
I just met her. A little bit?
A little poopsie bit.
Well, I thought... I thought she was interesting, that's for sure.
Well, not as interesting as reindeer.
Well, so what? A reindeer's my best friend. It's not that weird.
Little bit!
All right, let's just get the story straight.
Okay.
Now, Princess Anna meets a rugged and fearless ice harvester.
Who?
Kristoff.
Get out. Ow.
Cutting bravery helps get her up the North Mountain. 1, 2, 3, 4. I declare a zombie. You sleep through all of Arendelle History 101?
Catch me outside. Have a day. Never call me dreamy.
No, I sure don't. Okay, so, Princess Anna, now with the help of Sven and Kristoff, started to make the long, cold journey to the North Mountain. They navigate dark woods. Werewolves attack their sled!
Werewolves!
Just wolves.
Just wolves! They lose his freshly lacquered sled in the process.
Oh, gosh.
It explodes like Mariah Carey's career.
They came across a beautiful glen covered with beautiful icicles and twinkly snow. It was very romantic.
And the real hero of our story enters the picture, a snowman named...
He likes warm hugs and summer.
A snowman that likes summer? How can you not love this guy?
Winter's a good time to stand and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a... Cuddle! Anna
to go away freezes her heart.
Accidentally.
When she learns of Arendelle's fate.
She sends Marshmallow
out. Giant snowman, 10 feet tall.
No, 20.
30!
Anna and Kristoff almost die jumping off an icy cliff. Luckily, the snow cushions their fall.
We learn that Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair is turning white, so Kristoff takes her to the love.
Trolls who tried to marry Kristoff and Anna.
Even though she's still engaged to Prince Hans of the Southern Isles.
Who's she? Just man.
Okay, everybody's a bit of a fixer-upper. But it's too late. Anna's growing colder by the minute. And as Poppy said...
Only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
But, like, why is he British?
I have no idea. So there you go, Prince. After you're going to find lots of our frozen heart where true love's kids see true love.
Prince Hans leads a group of men to capture Elsa. Not a cool move, Hans.
Well, Kristoff gets on into Hans, and he leans in to give her a big kiss when...
He laughs in her face.
He laughs in her... Wait, what? Hans is a bad guy?
Yeah, he's all like, oh-ho! He's all in hope to freeze, blames Elsa, sends her to death so we can take over the kingdom!
Hans is a bad guy.
Only thing worse are people who yell puddle.
Escapes from prison, and she tries to run away across the fjord. She runs like this because she's in heels.
Let go, let go!
But Hans is in hot pursuit. Meanwhile, Olaf is rescuing Anna.
He likes it. Kristoff, not Hans, is her true love.
Speaking of the pungent reindeer king, he's racing back across the fjord. This is Elsa Storm's reason of fever pit.
I don't think anyone had a fever in that blizzard.
But I'm Jing. Out in the fjord, Anna is running. Okay, she's shuffling towards Kristoff because she's starting to freeze. Then she sees Hans is getting ready to kill her sister. She's in the blizzard torn. Should she save herself? Should she save her sister? What to do?
I don't know.
Well, make something up.
Make it up.
Sure.
Olaf kisses Anna.
Maybe not that.
Talking snowman. It's the act of true love that can thaw a frozen heart.
Uh-huh.
Everyone lives happily ever after. Because some people are worth nothing for. The end! Yeah. Thank you!
That guy's got a weird laugh.
Yeah, he does.
Sounds like my Uncle Marty.
Your Highness.
Oh, again.
She brought that other guy.
Other guy.
Name's Kristoff.
Krispy Kreme.
Are you crying? Something's happening.
It's getting really cold in here.
Hey, everyone. Who do you think that could be?
Well,
what a very good story you told, though the ending did feel strange.
Oh!
Well, Olaf did help a lot.
It was you who saved your sister and yourself.
Well, an act of true love will thaw a frozen heart. You're my sister, Elsa. I love you.
Queen Elsa, excuse me. The citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land did a swell job singing our anthem.
It was as if they had heard these songs before.
Well, for knowing our history so well, I hereby declare you all honorary citizens of Arendelle. Wonderful! You all made the Kingdom of Arendelle proud! Thank you for coming! Great job!
Goodbye, Queen Elsa!
Bye, Princess Anna!
And goodbye, Kristoff!
Yes, finally!
We should go too!
Thank you all so much for coming out.
Especially because the comedic guys instead, they're hilarious, they make the story even better. Right now we're heading over to Rock and Roller Coaster for a fast pass and just walking down the street.
It's not as busy as yesterday.
Yeah, it's definitely not as busy as yesterday. But I like it, so. Yeah, enjoying our last couple hours too. And then we'll head to Grandma Grandpa's house and hang out there too. And, oh, I love it here. Our final shopping of the trip. Here, kind of sad. I don't want to leave, but it's all good. We'll be back soon. Goodbye. Thank you. I have a complete trust that we're going to come back this year. And yeah, kind of a bummer, but also exciting to know that new adventures await us. And get to see that later. So, thank you, Lord, for this time here right now. Place to stay.
Yep.
Thank you, Lord, for that. Yeah. To our grandparents' house to see Connor and hang out with him in the pool and hang with our grandparents and do all that fun stuff and relax for like the last day while we are on our way there. I understand that we're leaving, but you know, we're grateful for what we got to do and.
This one longing to be dinner, that one wants to get the girl, and do I hope him? Yes, indeed.
Turn right onto Sherbrooke Road.
Goodbye, Animal Kingdom Lodge. We love you much.
Stop
we
saying.
Are going to watch the last bit of Avatar go bye-bye in the distance.
Grandparents' house, so that's fun. It's kind of a good drive. It was beautiful too. Lots of trees and stuff that you don't see in Colorado. Sadie's sleeping. Adorableness. But yeah, we're heading over to our grandparents' house, almost there. Yeah. It's kind of fun to rewatch some of the videos from this trip and kind of like the part, this part we just ended and. I remember what I felt while we were watching that in real life.
In a half mile, turn left onto Hudson Avenue.
That's the nice part about doing a vlog is you can rewatch the cool stuff you've got to do and, you know, and see everything you've done and kind of be thankful for everything you do and all the stuff you get to remember and have memories of. How close are we?
2 minutes.
Oh, I'd say that's pretty close. Isn't it just down this road?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Chill. Watch our movie.
I'm gonna grab myself a phone.
Army men.
Special grandma food. The best. Thank you, grandma, for making dinner.
You can blow on it.
You
probably need salt.
Say hi, Connor.
Hi.
Oh, right here.
What is that, Connor?
Popcorn.
Yeah, where is it from?
Disney World.
Okay, so we made it back to our grandparents' house. That's how I feel. I am so tired. It's not even funny. I didn't expect to be this tired after just, like, hanging out at the Hollywood Studios and then going home here to lay down and relax and have dinner. But, Anyway, I'm gonna get my papers on. Oh my god, go to bed. So, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!